here at GoJacks.com cross country weekly update with head coach Rod DeHaven. Let's recap a couple weeks ago up in Fargo, a good performance from your teams, especially the newcomers.
Yeah, I thought, a lot of our first year kids, responded well to the environment, which was pretty relaxed, smaller meet, and did a good job of hopping on the bus and just going out and competing. On the guys' side, Joseph Miner, did a lot of the heavy lifting during the race. I think led Ben Olson and Tom Brickman kind of through the middle stages, and then Tom had a strong finish to finish up well. And in general, the guys, you had some different things going on. I think some of our redshirt freshman guys were pretty anxious and kind of paid the price for that and went backwards a little bit as the race went on, which we'll have to work on. And then Micah Mather and Gabe Peters, I think they ran really solid. They weren't super aggressive, but did what they needed to do. And I think, kind of the ultimate cliche of the opening part of the season, busted off a little rust and, they'll be better the next time out. And on the women's side, Ellie Friesen, who we expected to do well, I thought ran a really smart race. The young lady from North Dakota State ran a great race and kind of broke away early, and Ellie just kind of bided her time with the second pack. And when she was instructed to make a move, she was able to do that and got away from the main group and finished pretty strong for her first race. And that's kind of what we'd hoped for. And hopefully we can build on that as the season goes. And that will certainly be a huge compliment to our upperclassmen that some of them sat out in that first race.
Anything to take away from, running against a couple conference teams with North Dakota State and North Dakota up there?
I think, both those schools ran well. I'm sure there are probably things they want to work on as well, but I thought, North Dakota State, in particular on the women's side, looked very strong. And, but we really don't know where we're at. And with a 4K distance as opposed to 6K, and a lot of season in front of us, certainly I don't think a lot of people are going to remember what happened at the Bison Open, by the time, even the time the middle of October comes around.
This weekend, back at it, down in Nebraska, preview to that event down there.
This is something we haven't been to in a while, the Woody Greeno, Jay Dirksen Invitational. Takes on probably greater importance this year in terms of University of Nebraska, as they're hosting the Big Ten Championships at the end of October. And instead of its usual venue at Pioneer Park, they're going to Mahoney Golf Course on the northeast side, which is probably pretty flat, pretty friendly, and not going to get really anybody into any sort of trouble physically, other than probably the heat, which would be pretty typical this time of year in mid-September. And so it's brought, I think, a higher level of competition to this particular meet. So we'll see some really quality programs from a Division I perspective. The Air Force Academy, men and women have been very solid over the years. Michigan's women been perennial Big Ten champs. Those are the two programs that really stick out. Wyoming's women, I think, will be there as well, which I think that's a program that's definitely improving. And then we'll see, five teams from the Summit League, including ourselves. So that's, I think, probably a better gauge of kind of where we're at. But I think largely we just have to focus on, kind of where we're at, trying to get better each week. And, on the men's side, trying to get everybody back healthy and into the lineup. And, again, another great opportunity to see where some of our first year kids are at. And, where some of the other younger people, if they can step up and, help us out this week.